Hi, do you know what is the most searched query on Google? It's not IPL or Bollywood. It is, what is wrong with me? Yes, it's Google before doctors. But hey, do you really want to take the word of someone who may not know any better than you and me? Hi, I'm Vineetha Athrey and I'm a journalist and an author. And I welcome you to Mallige Answers, where I catch up with renowned doctors from Mallige Hospital to answer questions on health and well-being. Join me. Welcome to Mallige Answers. I'm Vineetha Athrey and I'm in conversation with renowned gastroenterologist Dr. Dheeraj Karanth. Hello, Doctor.
Hello. Hi.
Doctor, if you're talking about gastro problems, alcohol can't be far behind. In fact, a lot of doctors clearly indicate that this is the bad boy. And we all kind of have a cursory idea why, but no one really understands what really happens in the stomach or in the GI area or in the liver due to consumption of alcohol. Can you throw some light on that?
Well, alcohol, if you ask me, is a poison. It's a poison to the body. Oh. It can affect different organs in different ways. Mm-hmm. And when it gets into the liver, mm-hmm. the metabolism of alcohol or the digestive process in the alcohol causes it to, sort of leave some toxic or dangerous metabolites which damage the liver. It damages the liver cells, likewise in the stomach, and it gives rise to a change called fibrosis. Mm-hmm. Wherein the liver starts doing a change. First it causes fat in the cells, then it damages the cells, causes them to go into a fibrotic stage wherein a lot of fibers are laid down. Mm-hmm. And this leads to what is called a cirrhosis or shrinkage of the liver, which has its own set of problems. Sometimes an acute alcohol intoxication can damage all the cells in the liver, causing alcoholic hepatitis, which is again immediate jaundice and a life-threatening disease. So it can cause cirrhosis in the long run, it can cause severe alcoholic hepatitis, it can cause an acute gastropathy wherein it causes damage to the stomach cells because of its toxic nature, leading to pain and vomiting.
And what happens in the cases of cirrhosis and fatty liver?
Well, there are two types of fatty liver. Number one is one that is caused by alcohol. Number two is the one that is caused by the lifestyle.
So that is non-alcoholic
fatty liver. Non-alcoholic fatty liver. That's the next in thing, in the sense it's going to cause a lot of deaths in the future.
Really? So it can be fatal?
Yes, it can
lead
to cirrhosis.
And what triggers?
Well, it comes back to the lifestyle again. Yeah, so diabetes of long-standing duration. People who have what is called as a metabolic syndrome, they have cholesterol, they don't exercise, they eat three times a day, good fatty, high-calorie meals, but they don't burn it. And of course, they have a genetic predisposition to develop damage because of this type of lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Because you can see many people who do all this and still are healthy, but there are a large chunk of people who do this but cannot, tolerate this. The body doesn't tolerate it. So okay. These are the groups of people with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease who tend to accumulate fat in the liver. And then like in the cirrhotic patient, because of alcohol, it lays down fibers and shrinks, then becomes cirrhosis. So it's going to be the next epidemic that's going to come in because of our lifestyle. Yeah.
When you say lifestyle diseases, it seems like it's something entirely preventable. So what are the changes that one must do in one's lifestyle to make sure it doesn't escalate?
Well, if you're a diabetic, good control of diabetes. If you have cholesterol, good control of lipids and cholesterol. If you don't have either of these, but you still have a fatty liver without alcohol, even if you're thin, you need to sort of exercise daily, a 40-minute brisk walk, a jog for 5 days a week, eat a lot of fresh fruits, fiber and vegetable mm-hmm. with each meal, cut down the calories and probably lose a kg or two of weight if you're obese, will make a huge difference to the liver.
And is it an irreversible disease, cirrhosis?
Well, cirrhosis is an irreversible disease, but fatty liver is not.
Okay.
So if you're catching it at the time of fatty liver, it can be reversed. But if you're catching it when it is cirrhosed or shrunken, well, the train has started. You just can slow it down.
Oh, and what is the treatment option or what is the option at all?
Well, once cirrhosis develops, to slow it down, again, the same lifestyle, you slow it down. If there is a virus that is causing cirrhosis, you treat the virus.
And then it goes away.
The cirrhosis doesn't go away. Okay. Cirrhosis never goes away. Once cirrhosis starts, like I said, The destination is death. The train has started. By controlling your lifestyle, by controlling the virus, the control of alcohol use, you slow down the process.
Mm.
You buy time. So it's wise not to allow cirrhosis to develop. So in that way, prevention plays a great role. Yeah.
And normally, how is it treated?
Well, if you have cirrhosis, we first try and see whether there is a reversible cause, like a lifestyle for a non-alcoholic fatty liver, alcohol use for an alcoholic, viruses for virus-related diseases, and treat them accordingly. Like stop alcohol, change your lifestyle, treat the virus. Well, after that, you treat the complications of cirrhosis. Some people can have blood vomiting, water in the abdomen, drowsiness, altered sensorium, kidney damage. So as and when a complication develops, treat them so that you buy the time. But
it's more like management rather than cure.
Yes, but
point.
Then there is cure. You get a surgery called a liver transplant nowadays, wherein you change the liver from a young or a middle-aged donor who has died in an unfortunate accident or due to some unforeseen event. So if the liver is healthy and if you are willing to donate, you change the liver of the person who has a liver cirrhosis, they will do extremely well. They will do it. Liver transplantation is a permanent cure, but then it has to be done in the right indication. And life after transplant is not as easy as it was before transplant. You need to be on a lot of medicines to prevent the liver from being rejected by the body.
Mm.
There can be repeated infections. And of course, you should see that the cause that caused the cirrhosis in the first stage does not come back. Like alcohol use or bad lifestyle shouldn't come back. So that's the cure. Liver transplantation is the cure. But it's not easy as of now in this country.
What are the symptoms really? I mean, whether you have alcoholic fatty liver, non-alcoholic fatty liver, cirrhosis, what are the red flags that one should look out for?
Well, fatty liver does not have a red flag. You have to pick it up on an investigation by doing an ultrasound. Some people with cirrhosis, if they are well compensated, don't have any symptoms again. They develop a symptom in the form of a complication, water in the abdomen, swelling of the legs, yellow color of the eyes, lack of appetite, and sometimes they come with blood vomiting or passing black colored stools. Sometimes they come with pain in the abdomen when the blood flow to the liver gets blocked. Sometimes they come with decreased urine output. But a very catastrophic presentation would be a person who comes to you with drowsiness and altered sensorium because the liver is damaged, not able to filter the blood, and it goes to the brain causing all sorts of funny behavior. So these are most of the symptoms of cirrhosis. But a fatty liver is silent. You have to pick it up by doing an ultrasound.
So is it a good idea to kind of include ultrasound as part of your regular medical checks and at least once in a couple of years or so?
They do it as a master health checkup in most places nowadays. I would recommend it as a good idea to, in these couple of years, do your exercise, eat healthy, be healthy. Well, that's the way to go. Not to be scared about a disease.
All right. So thank you very much, doctor.
Okay.
Exercise, eat healthy and just be healthy. And that seems like the best way to avoid gastrointestinal disorders. We're talking to Dr. Dheeraj Karanth and come right back and keep watching Mallige Answers.